Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize column headers and data in a Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid using templates. Let's start with the coding part. I open my existing Blazor WebAssembly app, which already has the Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid package installed. On the index.razor page, I have included the basic TreeGrid rendering code. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component, please refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. You can visualize employees' details in a TreeGrid with this code. I'll run this application to show the TreeGrid. Here, the TreeGrid is displayed with the hierarchical data. First, I'll show you how to apply an icon to the employee ID column using the header template option. I remove the header text property from the employee ID TreeGrid column and add the header template tag inside that column. Then I add the span element and provide the custom header title as ID. Here I can include the built-in or custom icon using the font face CSS rule. I include the style element and specify the custom font to display the text or icon using the font face CSS rule. I also define the icon class e-icon-user-login and define the icon styles. Now I'll use this icon class name in the span element. Look at the TreeGrid header. An icon is added to the employee ID column. Next, I will show you how to customize the employee data using a template option. To demonstrate this, I will add another TreeGrid column tag and set the header text as employee image and width to 140 pixels. To design the column template, I add the template tag. Then I declare the variable employee details and use the implicit context parameter to access the employee data. Here, I'm going to display the employee image. In this sample, I have already added the images under the root folder. You can find this sample's link in the description section. To manage navigation to the images, I inject the microsoft.aspnetcore.components.navigationmanager URI helper and use it to retrieve images from its path inside the image element. Then in the style element, I define the styles for the image element. I set the height and width to 60 pixels and set the vertical alignment as a baseline. Let's have a look at the TreeGrid now. The employee image column is included in the TreeGrid columns based on the specified template. Finally, I will show you how to use conditions inside the TreeGrid column template. Here I want to display the employee confirmation status using a checkbox. To demonstrate this, I add another TreeGrid column and set the header text property to confirmed. I set the text align property to center and width to 100. Then I add the template property. Here, to render a Syncfusion checkbox, I include the namespace syncfusion.blazor.buttons. Then I add the SF checkbox tag and checked property. To this checked property, I need to assign a Boolean value. So, I write a condition to check whether the employee has confirmed by accessing the employee details using an implicit context parameter. Checking the TreeGrid now, we can see the confirmed column is displayed with a checkbox. Also, the checkbox is rendered in a checked state for employees who are confirmed. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. In this video, I showed you the ways to customize column headers and data in a Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid using templates. In my next video, I'll cover another interesting topic. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, Give it a like and subscribe to our channel.